Hello guys, and welcome here to the Richmond International Raceway. I'm Brian James up here in the booth with you today. And we welcome today. We're here for the 24th race of the season, I believe. And it's also a big race because after today, there are only two races. Auto Club, Chicagoland. The two races that stand between making the chase and I'm standing on the outside. Big announcement came this week. For those of you who do not know, we mentioned that this is season one of the Straight Talk series. We thought there would be a season two. There is not a season two. So this is the one and only chance to make a Straight Talk series chase. So definitely a lot at stake here, for the guys in this series. Like I said, my workload got a little busier, so it will kind of keep me from recording a season two of this series. There will be a Cup Series next season, though, if I can do it. Like I said, if you follow the Facebook page, be sure to keep up to date on that, so you know whether or not, you know, what's going on and stuff. Gabriel Wanderley is on the pole. Zach Buchanan will start in second. Sabrina Rogers in third. Keon Eddington in fourth. Zach Rogers will start fifth. Starting sixth is Alan Eberhard. Starting seventh is Morgan Carson. Eighth, Tommy Turbo. Ninth, Corey Williams. And in tenth is DJ Curtis. Who will join the chase grid today? Happy 2017. Let's take you to your starting lineup here from Richmond. Coming through the final turn. Like we said, this is after today, two races stand between these guys in the chase. Who will add their name to the grid? We're going to find out. Gabriel Wanderley, Zach Buchanan, his dream are underway. Gabriel Wanderley off to a very fast start here today, and he needs it. He has one win on the season so far, I believe one. His sister, Elba Wanderley, picked up her third win of the season just a few short days ago at Nashville. And she is now the number one seed in the chase. A win today by her could solidify her as the number one seed. Sabrina Rogers in second. She's had a great year. Just no wins to show for it. A win would propel her into the chase more than likely, based on her point position. So she's going to push really hard today, try and get in. Zach Buchanan also has a win, but he is borderline making the chase with his one win. A win today could move him up in chase grid and pretty much lock him in. We'll have to wait and see if he can do it. We mentioned next race at Auto Club, then we head to Chicagoland, where the final chase grid will be determined. And that's when we start the playoff bracket, pretty much. And I believe we just had a wreck. Caution is out. Cole Vaughn, that is not good for him. He was borderline making the chase. He was on the outside, way on the outside looking in. He will, that kind of wreck will unfortunately allow him to miss the chase. They are coming to the pit lane, I believe, this time. Nope. So we'll go see what happens. 97 was trying to force 3 wide, and it just wasn't working. You see how much Taylor Wish in there, Corbin Flaherty, unfortunately. Just not a very smart move there. Anyway, we'll take you back to the green right now. There we go, so no one is out of the race yet. Gabriel Wanderley will be us back to the green. Sabrina Rogers in second. Zach Buchanan third. Lauren Carson fourth. Alan Everhard fifth. And that's your top five as we are back underway here at Richmond. A great restart for the number 16. He has been killing them on the restart. There goes the 8, Zach Buchanan. He's looking for second. Does he have it? As these two battle, that 16 is slowly creeping away from him. I think he's got it. Side by side in turn 3 still. They cannot decide who wants to be in second. And finally they do. Zach Buchanan will take it. And now he will try to eat away at this 8.5 tenths of a second lead. My apologies there. My apologies, I'm working through a fold as well, so. Anyway, Gabriel Wanderley has pulled away. He's about a second ahead now. If he's got a win today, could propel him even further on the chase grid. I believe this would move him to the number 2 seed if he could win today. Man, these Roush cars are very hard to stop in this series. It's remarkable, the season that they've had. .2 now is the lead. We mentioned that we go to Auto Club next race. Then Chicagoland, which is a double points race, and the final one of the season. Next race on this channel will be the Cup race here at Richmond, which is usually the race that decides the chase. It is not this season. We head to Richmond for the Cup race. That is not a double points race either. I should mention as caution is back out. Oh! Sam Curtis hit the pit wall. That will definitely dampen his chase hope. Wow! And they make their way on the pit lane. Every time I try to speak about what's coming up on this channel, every time I try to do promos, it's just, wow, wrecks occur. Corey Williams might have been involved. Somehow they come on the pit lane. As you take a look, the pit road camera's not that good, so that's what we're going to do right there. Here they come. Gabriel Wanderley will win the race off. Let's go see what happened. Sam Curtis, I don't think he saw these guys slowing down, or he just didn't have enough time to react. Corey Williams had blown the engine on his car, which was the initial cause of the caution. Sam Curtis just didn't see what was ahead of him. Let's speed this up a little bit. There we go. So must be trying to get to the pit lane. Alan Everhard's already there. So nowhere to go for him. And, he thought he had enough room to make that dive onto the pit lane. Sam Curtis and Corey Williams done for the day, unfortunately. Let's take you back to the green. Pace car will peel off this time. Corey Williams lost the clutch, and Sam Curtis is an accident. It'll be great. Gabriel Wanderley, Sabrina Rogers, Keon Addington, Paul Lambert, and Zach Buchanan in the top five. We're back underway, and we are over halfway past the race. And Sabrina Rogers making a move. Gabriel Wanderley did not have an incredible restart that time, and he's also got front end damage. He must have hit someone trying to slow down for the caution. And Sabrina Rogers to the lead. We had mentioned Sabrina Rogers not winning this season yet. Ace Beck and Ace Rogers both in the chase so far. A win by Sabrina would propel her into the chase, and then the Rogers siblings would all be in the chase. Or at least all in chase contention. So you can imagine Zach in that 20 getting a little antsy, knowing his sister could possibly get in the chase today. Here comes Zach Buchanan. He is making moves for second. He overshot it and took it. Zach Buchanan thinks he has a shot today in that JBM car. These guys got the news at the driver's meeting that there was not going to be a season two. So you can imagine the desire for season one and only championship here in this series just, like I said, it increased the desire for this championship. Here comes Gabriel Wanderley again. He's looking for second. He's going to get it. Sabrina Rogers will try and get away. And she's got to be thinking right now, please, please let this go my way. She's got about a 0.7 second lead. Man, oh man, and these two still battling it out for the second spot. Zach Buchanan doing everything he can to get it. And the more these two battle, I think the happier that 19 is getting. And Zach Buchanan will take it back over and will set his sights on the 19. Gabriel Wanderley had dominated this race, led the most laps today. Could be all for nothing at this point, except for points. Here comes Zach Buchanan. That 8 is getting larger in the rearview mirror of the 19. And she should be worried right now. 10 laps to go. I'd be worried seeing that 8 getting a little closer. Someone should start playing the Jaws theme music. Or maybe a little too soon for that. She extended the lead again. He gained a little that time. He's in the frame. Damn it. Sorry, I can't play the Jaws theme music, so I'm just gonna undo that. Maybe I'll just stick to commentating. Here he comes again, he's closing it even more. This is going to be an interesting finish. Even more in the frame now, that gap is closing. Almost 3.5 tenths a second behind. And he's going to gain a little that time, not a good exit for Zach Buchanan on turn number 2. He's going to lose just about all the ground he gains. He might gain a little back here. He seems to gain a little one lap, lose a lot the next. And he's going to have to really buckle down in the final five laps if he wants a shot. He lost some ground now. Four to go this time. This Zach Buchanan game, he lost ground. That could be it. Gabriel Wanderley is not even able to pick off some ground. Looks like Zach Buchanan got a good exit, but it's not going to be enough to make a substantial gain. Three to go this time. We also can factor in pit stops as a possibility in these final laps. Here he comes. He's closing once again. Down to half a second with two to go. It could turn into a drag race. Not if he lost it again. So coming to the white flag, Sabrina Rogers will lead them. Both of her Joe Gibbs teammates have been the victory lane this season. Cole Vaughn at Texas, I believe Zach Rogers, just a few short races ago. I can't remember where it was. Out of the final corner, Sabrina Rogers, and now the whole Joe Gibbs Racing team has won. Sabrina Rogers will claim her first of the season here today at Richmond. She will now add her name to the mix for the chase. Great race for Sabrina. Zach Buchanan did everything he could on that final few laps, getting second. This wasn't meant to be safe for them. Excuse me. Man, that's a tough race for them, but they have a lot to look forward to. And definitely definitely gained a lot of points in this race for them, which is always good. It'll help them in their run towards Chase. Anyway, we want to thank you for watching. We'll see you at Auto Club, or we'll see you for the Cup race, which is coming up shortly from Richmond. Here are your results and standings. Goodbye, everyone.